Hey guys, so today's video is about overpriced makeup. So I went on just a bunch of different websites where I can find makeup, and I went high to low on the pricing, and I'm here to bring you guys the most overpriced makeup slash skincare slash beauty product that I could find for you guys. And if you like this video, if you like the concept, comment down below, let me know to do a part two. The more comments, the more likely I am to find more stuff and do it again. So subscribe, hit that bell, like, comment for engagement. Social media will be in description, and let's just get into it. Okay, I'm gonna move so that we can actually put the pictures on the side, because I usually forget and then it gets really annoying while I'm editing. Of course it does. I went on Cult Beauty and I did Selfridges, I did Harrods, which are like two very, very high-end stores in the UK, and then maybe some other things, but those were my main picks that I was going for. So we have this Hourglass Vegan Brush collection. So it's not even natural hair. Natural hair brushes are usually more expensive because they're from an animal. It's kind of like buying fake fur versus real fur. It's going to be really expensive. So Hourglass Vegan Brush, so it's synthetic hair, and this is a 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14 15 16 17 piece brush set, including some dual ended ones, which then adds two extra brushes technically. So it's 19 brushes for £640. Look, I love a high-end brush. I love a good high-end makeup product. I do like designer stuff, but to spend £640 on synthetic brushes, mind-boggling to me. Mind-boggling. I think there is a nice in between when it comes to brushes. You don't have to get super, super cheap. You don't have to get super, super expensive. I feel like you can get somewhere in between and get a good look. Like, I just, most of my brushes are like BH Cosmetics, e.l.f., which are my more affordable ones. And then I have Zoeva and Sigma for my less affordable ones. And I feel like Zoeva and Sigma are like the limit to how expensive I'll go with brushes. And I feel like that's where the quality is capped. Like, I feel like at that point, past Sigma and Zoeva, you're just not going to get a better quality for the price. You're just going to get a higher price tag and a different brand. I don't think the quality is that much better, okay? I recently bought Pat McGrath brushes. I bought two. One concealer one and one highlighter one that everyone uses for foundation, contour, stuff like that. And I think they're overpriced. They feel really cheap. They feel really light. They're tiny. Like, the handle is not super long. And they're just super light. Like, they're super cheap feeling. And they're not, like, amazing. I used them a few times just because I was like, I already paid for it, I might as well just like use it a few times. And they're not that amazing, so I just stopped using them, and they haven't become like cult classic faves for me the way some of my Sigma brushes have become, the way some of my Zoeva brushes have become. And I think the brushes are like £30 each, which was such a waste of money. I just don't think with brushes the quality to price thing goes up at the same time. I feel like it goes up at the same time for a while, and then price starts to go up and quality just evens out, and at that point, like, you're spending too much on brushes. Do you know what I mean? The graph just doesn't make sense. So I just don't really agree with this. Next, Victoria Beckham Beauty. So there's the Cell Rejuvenating Regimen, the Healthy Skin Set. It's two products, a serum and another serum situation, right? And it's £300. For £300, I want a new face. I want a new face. Okay, £300 is a crazy price tag, because I literally just bought the Glow Recipe Glow Cafe, which is one of every product that they released, I'm pretty sure, or like most of their collection, and it normally costs £322, and I got it for 200 and something because it was on a 40% discount. So for 200 and something pounds, I got like full skincare from eye cream to serums, niacinamide, vitamin C, like all of it, versus these two products that was supposed to like rejuvenate my, no. Next, Surratt Artistique face brush, one singular face brush for £240. That's even more ridiculous than the Hourglass. The Hourglass, you got 19 brushes for 640. For 240, you get one singular face brush. I would be afraid to put any makeup on this brush. I would be afraid to wash it. I would be afraid to even look at it. It would just sit there in my collection because I would just be afraid. Yep, I just scared. Fear on my face when I look at this brush. It has a 5-star rating, but there's only one rating. There's one review. So do with that what you will, okay? But if it was up to me, 240 is a little bit too much for a face brush. Just saying, okay? Next, Christian Louboutin Beauty Rouge Louboutin Trio Collection. these expensive brands make such long names. Like, it's just like a bunch of words, a bunch of descriptive situations going on. Anyway, £219 for 3 lipsticks. And they're in the shape of like a necklace. But like, who's realistically going to wear that as a necklace? No one. I know they're trying to be like, good value for money because you can get like a necklace situation. No one's going to do that. Absolutely no one. I think this is insanity. Let's just move on. Yeah. If you want to talk about insanity, Hermes, yes, the Birkin, Kelly, Constance handbags, absolutely correct. Yes, that Hermes we're talking about. And like, look, I do think £10,000 for a handbag is a little bit much, but at least there's some history behind it. This kind of exclusivity, you buy it, you're guaranteed to make your money's worth and then some. It's an investment. It goes up in price, you know, to each their own. Some invest in houses, some invest in cryptocurrency, some invest in stocks, some invest in Hermes Birkins. But this is where I draw the line, okay? 24 lipsticks. First of all, it's a set of 24 lipsticks. Why do you need 24 lipsticks? Are you going to use all 24 shades? Are all 24 shades going to be something that you really enjoy? Is it going to be a case of you only really using one or two of the lipsticks because you only have one set of lips and you reapply lipstick maybe a few times a day if you're lucky? And you're never going to get through all of these lipsticks and you are actually getting a bunch of shades that you don't really want. But you can get some reds and burgundies. Maybe you're not a red and burgundy person. You really will like nudes, but you like pinky nudes. But then you got some brown nudes and you really don't like them. So you're going to have to start giving these away as presents to people. Anyway, other than all of that, the price tag. £1,400. £1,400. For lipsticks. Anyway, you guys... Look, I understand buying one Hermes lipstick, two, three, four, maybe five, but 24 for £1,400. Anyway, if you wanted something slightly less insanity, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, so 24 lipsticks by Gucci. Different packaging on all the lipsticks. Some there might be like different formulas or just different collections that they've had in a beautiful box. £875. Once again, 24 lipsticks. What are the chances that you're gonna love all of them and use all of them evenly, equally, and get through all of them? Slim to none. So you're spending £875 for just like adding lipsticks into your collection that you would have never added if it wasn't for this little vault situation. I just think it's wild to me. Let's just move on. Another lipstick box. So there's Byredo, very expensive brand. You get this wooden box, which I actually think of the three boxes, this one is the most, the highest value is added in the packaging. So the other ones are just like cardboard. Yeah, it's really pretty, but this one's a wooden box, so you can definitely reuse it for your lipsticks or keep them in there and keep it as like a little decoration piece on your vanity or wherever. Look, I get it. This is a bit of a, you know, statement, right? We're making a statement with this. Wooden box, it has a mirror, which is very nice. Wonderful. You get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, if I counted that correctly. 13 lipsticks, it's a little bit more of a reasonable amount. Either way, you're not going to use all of them. Either way, there are going to be some that you just don't enjoy at all, and you're going to have to give them away or just keep them around. But then, like, if you give some away, you're going to have this, like, missing thing in the box. Like, you're going to have some missing lipsticks. So anytime someone opens it, or if you want to keep it open, you're going to have missing lipsticks. You're going to keep them around. They're going to expire. Anyway, £580. £580 for lipsticks. Move on. Okay, then we have Guerlain, which very expensive, absolutely. We have this Lunar New Year for 2021 lipstick case and lipstick situation. It's a red lipstick in this metal case. I'm assuming you can like refill it or something. £230 for one lipstick. Now, for some reason, the Hermes one seems like a good deal because you're getting 25 lipsticks for £1,400 versus one lipstick for £230. And like, I get that Guerlain is a very expensive brand, but like Hermes carries a bit of weight to it, a bit more weight. I can't believe I'm justifying £1,400 on a lipstick case. But by comparison, it just seems like a better deal, no? La Prairie. La Prairie. The makeup is expensive, we know. I used to watch Tati's, you know, WTF Wednesday videos where she would review very expensive products, and La Prairie made a few appearances. Now, the Caviar Concealer Foundation with SPF 15, which is pathetic, give me 30 if you're going to give me anything at all, is £205. The most expensive I've bought is Chantecaille. It was £120 for 2 refills and I regret it to this day. The most expensive foundation that I actually enjoy that I bought and I would buy again is Pat McGrath Labs. I think it's £60. £205? At that point, it's not doing much better than like just regular high-end. Like, I'm not even talking about drugstore. I'm not talking about mid-tier. I'm talking about like Charlotte Tilbury is not going to look worse than this. And you can get like 3 or 4 or 5 Charlotte Tilbury's for the price of one of these. Do you know what I mean? So let's just move on. Chrome Hearts, never heard of the brand before, but they sell scented nail varnishes, 15 milliliter bottles, £180. £180. I never knew nail varnishes could be this expensive. I just don't think it's worth it personally. Next, Hourglass. Very interesting because Hourglass is high-end, but it's not considered designer. It's just considered high-end. But they recently released these eyeshadow fill situations. So you get a palette of one. It's like one container that fits one eyeshadow. A palette of 3, where you fit 3 singular eyeshadows, or a palette of 5. 5 eyeshadows, you get the point. So what you have to do is you have to buy the palette that you enjoy, 1, 3, or 5. And then you have to fill it with the singular eyeshadows, and then you can just refill whenever you run out of a shade. Now, if you want to actually curate a 5 pan of these eyeshadows, you have to pay £156 for 5 eyeshadows. Pat McGrath Labs, right, the 10 pans are £120, and you can get them on sale a lot of the time. For Natasha Denona, the big palettes are 115, the mid are like 60, the small ones are like 25. I remember she used to do really big ones for like £200-300, but they literally had like 20 shades of them. 5 pans for 150. I feel like even for Hourglass, that's really expensive. I don't know what they were thinking, but I haven't heard amazing things about the eyeshadows. If anything, like, I haven't heard anything, let alone amazing things. So I'm just very, anyway, if I'm the Selfridges winner for Beauty Awards 2021, that I don't know who decided on this. I'm going to be real with you guys. Okay, so then, La Mer, very expensive brand. Everyone loves the face cream. Everyone loves, you know, all of this stuff. But I went on Selfridges and they recently released a jumbo size of the La Mer face cream for anyone that's a huge fan of it. And it's a 500 milliliter tub, which is, look, big, right? But it's like it's big, but, you know, £1,700. £1,700. Normal face creams are like 100 to 200 milliliters and they might be 30 to 50, maybe £100, but £1,700. For that price tag, really, I am expecting a whole new face. Like, I know I said that with Victoria Beckham, but like, for £1,700, I want to look like a whole new human being, okay? Yeah, don't give me my same face back, just moisturize. I want new. I want reborn. Ugh. Even if I had billionaire money, right? I'm a billionaire and I have crazy money. Would I spend it on face cream? £1,700 for face cream. Just seems a little bit pointless to me. Anyway, next. La Prairie released this three bottle, Platinum Rare Rejuvenation Protocol. And it's £1,600. You guys know what I'm going to say. Anyway, along the same lines, we have the Platinum Rare Rejuvenation Cream, which is just a 50, not 500 with La Mer, okay? Now La Mer is sounding like the good deal, okay? 50 mil cream for £1,238. Why does La Mer sound like a good deal now? Why am I like debating on La Mer? I'm like, let me get this 500 mil, £1,700 face cream, because this one, you get 10 times less for roughly the same price tag. La Mer is giving all the good bargains out right now. Guerlain is releasing this treatment situation. I can't even attempt to pronounce half of these words. Anyway, it's basically supposed to just be some kind of a treatment for your face, and it's 4 vials that you have to use, and the vials are 15 milliliters each, 15 milliliters. That's like a travel size. That's like a generous
travel size?
I just bought some travel size perfumes and they're 10 milliliters. And I think from what I found out with perfumes, that's about 120 sprays. £1,075. No, thank you. I'm fine without it, actually. Then we have La Prairie coming back with their Rejuvenation Elixir. It's 30 milliliters, 30, for £1,068, as well as their Rare Cellular Night Elixir, 20 mil. That's basically a travel size. It's a deluxe travel size, a deluxe sample, for £1,068. Garland also has, with the one I couldn't pronounce, the black cream, and it's refillable. We love eco-friendly. It's refillable. It's 50 mil, 50, for £995. And then Garland from the same line also has the Ritual Discovery Ritual set. It comes with three different products and it's £878. Oh my god. Then we have La Mer that came out with a collection gift set. It's the Renaissance de la Mer collection. It's a gift set, you get some savings on it, good bargains, and it's four products. Why can't I count? There's a serum, there's, you know, cream, all of that stuff, and it's £845. Sounds like a bargain compared to the 15 milliliter vials for £5,500. That's an exaggeration, but you guys know what I'm saying. Then we have Sisley, of course, very expensive, but I didn't think it was this expensive. So you get the, I can't pronounce any of these, but anti-age liqueur four set situation for £775. Why am I whispering? Anyway, Dr. Barbara Sturm. I've had a face cream from Dr. Barbara Sturm, as well as a face cleanser. And it's this super anti-aging serum. It's 100 milliliters. The face cream I had wasn't that great. Like, it was okay. It wasn't the best. And the face cleanser I have isn't, like, that amazing. I got them free from Cult Beauty. I can't imagine spending £720 on an anti-aging serum. Because realistically, after using it and finishing it, I should look like a fetus. I should look unborn. Then we have, didn't know this was a thing, right? Check and Speak have these gold-plated manicure sets for £545. Them being gold plated add anything to my nail cutting abilities? Is it gonna make it like it's gonna cut through anything? No? Okay, move on with my life. That is like actually wild to me. They have Bond number 9. So there's these lipsticks that they release that are Queen's Swarovski lipsticks. So the casing is Swarovski crystals and it's £425 per lipstick. See, now Hermes and Gucci with the 25 lipstick sets sound reasonable. They sound like bargains, right? £425 for one lipstick. I don't want to think about it. For La Prairie, the Rejuvenation Ritual set that they had, like the products I showed you guys, and then they have another one called the Luxury Holiday Ritual. Both of those you can buy in sets rather than individual products I was showing you guys, and those sets will run you about £3,000 to £3,700. For like six, seven products. It's, I just want to know, like, how do you get to the point, like, when do you decide to start spending this kind of money on skincare? Like, at what point in your bank account livelihood, at what point in your financial gain do you think, I think I make enough money to spend £3,700 on just like some skincare? I want to know, like, at what financial point that happens. Anyway, that'll be it for today's video. If you guys enjoyed it, give a thumbs up, comment down below, anything to comment down below, and subscribe to this video every time something happens or I think of something to do. So hit that bell to be notified when that's happening. Social media links, any of the links in the description. I'll see you in my next one. Bye, guys.